We'll continue on talking with the experts associated with NASA's Commercial Crew Program. Joining us now is Gennaro Caliendo. He also is based at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. He is the partner manager for Boeing, which is also one of the partners in the Commercial Crew Program. Gennaro, thanks a lot for joining us. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me, Kyle. Good morning.
Good morning. I talked to John Cowart just a few minutes ago and Sarah Wechter yesterday, and I kind of ask all of you the same thing so that everybody listening can get an idea of how you got here. And can you talk a little bit about yourself, where you came from, and how you ended up at NASA?
Let's see, Kyle. I grew up in New York on Long Island. That's where I actually went to school, but I've always had an interest in space and science and aerospace and specifically, and that's what drove me to go into school and study mechanical engineering. I guess from school, I kind of looked around but couldn't find any work, as most graduating college students run into these days, and it wasn't different 25 years ago. So I actually went to work in the construction business for a little while till a friend of mine, who was working at the Kennedy Space Center, asked me if I was interested in coming down, and I jumped at the opportunity. That was in 1987, and I've been basically a KSC employee ever since. I spent about 9 years working on the shuttle program as a structures engineer, and then moved on into the International Space Station program as they were ramping up their manufacturing of the different piece parts back in the mid-90s. And tried to lend a hand from our experience in assembly and operations, and went out to the factories and kind of picked up the parts and brought them back to the center for their final checkout and assembly.
Well, yeah, so you're obviously no stranger to not only shuttle, but obviously space station, and neither is the partner that you're working with, and that's Boeing. Can you talk a little bit about your role as a partner manager for Boeing's contribution to the Commercial Crew Program?
Sure. As everybody knows, Boeing's been in this business for a long time as well, and they've been building spacecraft going back to the early days of space travel, and of course with the space shuttle here most recently. And they are actually in the process of developing what's called the CST-100. It's a space capsule. They have recently here talked about or signed a partnership with ULA to provide the launch vehicle for them. And my role basically as the partner manager is to try and bring our team to their factory environment or their design environment and to give them some insight using our experience that we've gained over the past half century of spaceflight to help them as they design their spacecraft. It's pretty simple. Basically we partner up and we get together and we listen to their design and we read about their design, and then we provide the experts where they need it and where we think they need it.
Well, Boeing is obviously one of the companies that obviously understand the contract world because they've been in it for so long, and of course you are too, but. And now we're working under the Space Act Agreement, which is kind of milestone driven. So how is that being received on both sides when you both have worked under contract arrangements before, but now it's kind of a little bit different structure?
Yeah, that's a great question. You know, even for a company like Boeing, who's used to doing a lot of these things, it's a new world for both them and us. A lot of times they are so accustomed to the standard NASA contractor relationship that they almost look to us to kind of give them direction, and that's not really the role here in this relationship. We're here basically as a partner to give them some insight, but it's strictly their vehicle to develop, and they've been doing a real good job. They've been kind of getting used to the work and used to the environment, but you still have a lot of heritage people, and they still like the fact that we're there with them and trying to get us to kind of give them as much insight as possible into how to develop the spacecraft and what exactly NASA is looking for the future. Of course, that's not really what this partnership currently is all about. We're trying to get them to design a vehicle that perhaps we can go out and buy a ride on in the future.
Yeah, and part of that structure, obviously the hope to get to that point is to put a vehicle in low Earth orbit to deliver crews to and from the ISS, of course, and low Earth orbit. But the SAA structure is, you know, milestone driven. What are some of the milestones that Boeing has already met, and kind of what's the in front of them?
Yeah, we originally had about 11 milestones that were broken up over a 12-month period. We've added three more here to extend some work into the summer. That was part of the original plan that wasn't funded early on. But so far, they have done things like a systems definition review, phase zero safety review. Of course, they just recently here completed a preliminary design review of their CST-100 system. So they're pretty far along. And here in the future, we are going to get into some engine firings. They tested a launch abort engine. They are going to use a pusher system on this particular vehicle. And they were very successful in firing their engine here recently. And then they're going to do some more launch abort type and maneuvering engine system firings in the summer. And basically, they are doing all these piece parts in an effort to get their complete system designed and ready to go, so they can step into the next phase of SAAs with us with a fairly mature vehicle in terms of its design and in terms of the work that's going behind it to test out those designs.
Well, I asked John this a moment ago, and I like to ask all of you this because it's still a kind of a new environment, even though it's old hat to Boeing and yourself, obviously, but you're in kind of a new job working in this environment with commercial crew. But so how do you describe your new role to your family and friends, since they know what you did with shuttle and with station prior to this?
Yeah, it's interesting for us. And what I normally tell people and my family is that really what we are here to do is to try and help NASA and the U.S. government try and enable a new industry of taking humans into space. It's pretty simple. We have a goal of trying to figure out a way to get our astronauts to the ISS, of course, but at the same time, we're here as representatives of the government to produce or to help these industry people produce a vehicle that perhaps somebody like you or me can take a ride on in the future. Whether it's to go to a destination like the International Space Station or other space complexes that may be built at some time in the future for humans and perhaps our children and grandchildren.
Well, obviously that's the goal, and you're certainly a big part of trying to make that happen. So obviously we're in the International Space Station flight control room right now with ongoing operations, and it's a perfect environment for you to join us on the phone and tell us about what Boeing's doing, what you're doing in support of that. So, Gennaro, we really appreciate you stopping by and talking with us this morning. Thanks a lot.
Well, thank you for having me again, Colin, and hopefully we'll talk again in the future.
Hope so. I look forward to it. That's Gennaro Caliendo. He is the Commercial Crew Programs Partner Manager for Boeing.